In 2013, the Chicago police knocked on Robert McDaniel's door. They told him that their artificial intelligence technology had predicted he would be involved in a shooting. The thing is, they couldn't determine which side of the gun he'd be on. He could be the shooter, or he might get shot. Either way, their systems told them that he was at risk. But how can a bunch of calculations predict someone's future? Every day, all over the world, predictions and assumptions are being made about our lives. And it's all hidden within one special phrase that not many of us really understand. Artificial intelligence. We use AI to unlock our phones, to drive our cars, to help create our vaccines. But what actually is it? It's basically training computers to think and act like humans, to make decisions, to recognize speech, to be able to see, hear, and even smell. Now, it's easy to assume that because AI is computer-based and not human-based, it must be completely objective, and it couldn't possibly have any racial biases. That's just not the case. AI isn't magic. It forecasts the future based on the patterns of the past, and it finds these patterns in the data we train it with. The data feeding police AI, for example, is typically built around previous police stops and arrests, where people of colour have always been targeted and stopped at a far higher rate than white people. Because the AI is learning from our past behaviour, you can probably guess who the police are still targeting. And they can fall back on the technology by saying there's simply no way that computers can target certain people. These biases don't just exist in policing either. Facial recognition AI is becoming widespread and is the source of a growing number of problems. About 6 years ago, AI for Google Photos organized 80 pictures of black people into a folder called Gorillas because of the way their AI had been programmed. And until a few months ago, if you posted a photo of a black person and a white person on Twitter, only the white person's face would be shown in the preview. Actually, it does the same thing to cartoon characters. And even dogs. These systems are racist by design because they're learning from our inherently and systemically racist human behaviour. And as more and more everyday processes become automated by AI, the knock-on effects towards people of colour go far beyond these examples. So if our present data is predicting our future world, then we need to start thinking about the way we're living and what we're feeding it. Otherwise, we're simply teaching machines to be as racist as the rest of the world. Mm-hmm.